welcome to our today's section. Today we'll be talking about the cofactors. We know that enzymes, they catalyze the major reactions. Rather, all the reactions which are taking place inside the cell, they are catalyzed by the enzyme. These enzymes, we know, they make use of various cofactors, as we have discussed in our earlier lectures. So the cofactor which we'll be talking about today is this particular vitamin, B complex group vitamin, that is your B6, that is pyridoxine. If you look at the structure of this typical pyridoxine, now this pyridoxine, you'll find that it occurs in various forms. This form which you are now about to see is your pyridoxine form, right? This particular vitamin, it has different forms in which it occurs. Each vitamin, it occurs in different forms. Now this is its original form, that is the pyridoxine. So this pyridoxine, it has another form which we call as pyridoxal, where this particular group is converted into an aldehyde group. So you have another form of this, that is your pyridoxal. So you have another form of the same vitamin, that is your pyridoxal. So this particular pyridoxal, it looks something like this. So here you can see an aldehyde group has come into picture. All these vitamins, they act as the carriers of different cofactors. So this also gets converted into a typical coenzyme form, and then it acts as the carrier for what you call as different groups. Pyridoxine, basically it serves as a carrier of the amino group, remember. So the group which this particular pyridoxine is going to carry is your amino group. So this is the group which this particular vitamin is going to carry. After taking that particular group, this gets converted into pyridoxamine. So if you look at the pyridoxamine form, pyridoxamine will look something like this, right? So you have your pyridoxamine. So you have this particular pyridoxamine right here. So this is your pyridoxamine. So let me label it. Now this you know is pyridoxine. This what we have labeled is your pyridoxal, having an aldehyde group, and this having an amine group, that is your pyridoxamine. As I told that each vitamin, before it acts as the coenzyme, is converted into a coenzyme form. So the coenzyme form of this particular pyridoxine is your pyridoxal phosphate. So let us focus on this coenzyme form. The coenzyme form for this particular vitamin is your popularly called as PLP, pyridoxal phosphate. So in pyridoxal phosphate, what will be done is, here you will be having an addition of a phosphate group. So this will form what is called as your pyridoxal phosphate. If you add a phosphate group here, this gets converted into a pyridoxamine phosphate. So the coenzyme form is the pyridoxal phosphate. The group that is transferred, as I told, so the group that it transfers is your amino group. So the group which this particular vitamin or this cofactor is going to transfer is your amino group. And the group of enzymes where it functions, right? The general class of enzyme where it functions are your amino transferases. We also call them as amino transferases. So amino transferases or transaminases, these are the enzymes. So what exactly this particular pyridoxal is going to do, right? It is going to carry the amino group. So you have one particular donor. Now that donor will donate the amino group. Pyridoxal phosphate, it acts as the acceptor of this amino group. So amino group will come, it will attach here. This pyridoxal phosphate will get converted to pyridoxamine phosphate. Now this pyridoxamine phosphate, it acts as the donor. So this pyridoxal acts as the acceptor, pyridoxamine acts as the donor. So these are interconverted. So you have a donor, it gives the amino group, it gets converted pyridoxal phosphate into pyridoxamine phosphate. That amino acid gets converted to a keto acid. You have another incoming keto acid which will accept the amino group from pyridoxamine, and it will be converted to amino acid. So interconversions of amino acids, they are brought about by this particular PLP. To clarify this, let's look at the specific examples there. Now here you can see that you have a amino acid that is alanine. Now this alanine, you have a keto acid that is oxaloacetate. So here you can see that this, it has this amino group. So amino transferase enzyme, what it will do is, it will take this amino group from alanine. Once the amino group is taken from alanine, pyridoxal phosphate will take the amino group, get converted to pyridoxamine phosphate. Alanine here will get converted to pyruvate. So here you can see that your alanine, after donating
the amino group, it gets converted to what is called as your pyruvate, right?
And this particular oxamoacetate will now take the amino group from pyridoxamine phosphate. Pyridoxamine phosphate will give the amino group to this oxaloacetate, and your oxaloacetate, it will be converted to your aspartate.
So you have formation of the amino acid, that is your aspartate, right? So thus there is a transfer of what is called as your amino group.
Similarly, here also you can see you have amino acid. Again, we have here alanine, you have here alpha ketoglutarate, which is going to act as the acceptor. So this is the acceptor, this is the donor. So alanine, it will donate its amino group. Again, PLP will come, pyridoxal phosphate. Acceptor will accept the amino group from alanine. Again, alanine will get converted to pyruvate, right? And then this alpha ketoglutarate, it will accept the amino group. And after accepting the amino group, this gets converted to what is called as your glutamate. So the amino acid formed here in this case is your glutamate. Right? So here you will find that this particular pyridoxine, it acts as a transient intermediate carrier of the amino group. Thank you.